Hello, and welcome to another edition of Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Debbie. And Debbie asks, can I add a viability dye to my compensation controls? The answer is no, you can't add a viability dye to your compensation controls. A compensation control, by definition, must have a single fluorochrome and one fluorochrome only so that we can properly calculate compensation. If you have the viability dye in there, your software is going to see that viability dye as well in the background, and it's going to incorrectly calculate compensation. I would, in fact, encourage you to move to using beads rather than cells, because beads obey the three laws or three rules of compensation. That is, they'll capture the most antibodies, so they'll give you a bright signal. Because you have negative and positive beads, you can ensure that they have the same background fluorescence, which is the second rule. And of course, the third rule being that you have identical fluorochrome to what you're using in your experimental sample, especially with tandem dyes. Using the capture bead is great because you get the same exact fluorochrome. And in addition, of course, you don't have to waste your precious sample as a control. When I was doing work with mouse and I was doing bone marrow, the spleen was there, so we could use that as a control. But in the case of having a rare event or dim markers, using cells can be a be difficult to properly compensate. So I'd encourage you to go to use beads, and definitely do not add a viability dye to your compensation controls. Thanks for your question, and remember, if you have more questions, go to getflowtraining.com to learn more, or you can send me an email here at AskExcite@expertcytometry.com. Thanks for another Ask Excite. Until next time, stay tuned here for all your best practices in flow cytometry with me, Tim Bushnell, and Team Excite.